Anonymous says, if you have MTHFR, is it dangerous to supplement with cyanocobalamin rather than methylcobalamin? I've tried using sublingual methyl B12 and couldn't make any progress with increasing my B12 levels. Thoughts? I will mostly reference what I said before about the injections. And but in this case, the specific question is on MTHFR. So I guess I'll address the unique aspects of that. So what I had said before is I don't like cyanocobalamin. I prefer hydroxycobalamin. Methylcobalamin is fine. Adenosylcobalamin is fine. But hydroxycobalamin is the neutral form of vitamin B12. So if you're concerned about methylation-related issues, you would want to be careful with methylcobalamin supplementation in a way that you would not need to be careful about hydroxycobalamin supplementation. And so if you don't have a specific methylation-related goal, then I think hydroxycobalamin is the default, because that's the sort of like metabolically neutral B12, in that it's not predisposed to any particular system and it's not going to affect any system in a specific way, apart from just being nutritional B12. Then the second thing is, if you had MTHFR, is it dangerous to supplement with cyanocobalamin? Doesn't matter. I don't think MTHFR has anything to do with methylcobalamin, really. Now, your ending question is, I have tried using sublingual methyl B12 and I couldn't make any progress increasing my B12 levels. So I apologize for ranting for 15 minutes on something that has nothing to do with your case, but your problem is you can't get your B12 levels up. Your problem is probably that you have B12 malabsorption, and if you don't have malabsorption of everything else, you should look at the specific causes of B12 malabsorption, which are pernicious anemia and gastritis, including subclinical gastritis driven by H. pylori in the stomach.